In this question, we are given that an denotes the number of numbers which are having digits as 0 and 1, and in which we are not having any two consecutive zeros. And out of these number, whichever number ends in digit 1, number of those numbers is bn, and the digits which ends in digit 0, sorry, the numbers which ends in digit 0, number of those numbers cn. Now every number should start with 1, otherwise if I am starting with 0, I'll have one less digit, then it won't be representing an. Now say I am having this n digit number, then last digit will either be 0 or 1, will either be 0 or 1. This is nth digit. These are nth digit, right? Now I am supposed to keep track of the condition that you should not have two consecutive zeros, right? In an, either last digit will be 0 or 1, so I am separating this into two parts, right? So this and this together represents an. Now if last digit is 0, its previous digit has to be 1, otherwise if I am putting 0 over here, then you'll have two consecutive zeros. That means if this is 0, this is 1, just before that you can have 0, you can have, there is no problem. So if I am ensuring that up till here there is no two consecutive zeros, number of all such numbers is an minus 2, and after an minus 2 the number of ways of putting 1 and after 0 is only 1. So this is nothing but number of numbers in which I am not having two consecutive zeros and in which last digit is ending in 0. It has to be an minus 2 into 1 into 1, right? If last digit is 1, then just exactly on the same logic, if this digit is 1, before that I can have 0, I can have 1, no problem. Same thing is over here. If I am ensuring that up till here there is no two consecutive zeros, then over here the given condition will be satisfied. That means there won't be any two consecutive zeros. So if I am ensuring that up till n minus 1 place there is no two consecutive zeros, number of such numbers will be a n minus 1, and after that the number of ways of putting this 1 will be 1. So here a n will be a n minus 1 plus a n minus 2. That means according to the option, our first option is correct, that is A17 will be equals to A16 plus A15. So A option is correct, that is the answer. Now in the paragraph, the second question says what is B6. Now B6 means I am having 6 digit number which is ending in digit 1, so this is fixed. Any number should start with 1, so in between I am left with 4 options, these 4 options. Now in these 4 places I can put 4 ones. If I am putting 4 ones, then number of such numbers is 1. I can put 3 ones. Now 3 ones I can put any one of these 4 places. At one place I will put 0. Now that 0 can be placed anywhere, so number of those numbers will be 0, because I can put 0 over here, over here, over here, or over here. There's 4 such options. Or I can put 2 zeros or 2 ones. If I am putting 2 zeros, if I am putting 0 over here, that is at this place, then over here I have to put 1, and the remaining 0 can be placed over here or over here. So I am having 2 options. Similarly, in this case only, if I am putting 0 over here, then over here and over here, it has to be 1, 1, and 0 could be placed over here, that means 1 number. Right? If I am having 1 ones, that means I am supposed to put 3 zeros. Now, between these 4 places, if I am putting 3 zeros, it is not possible that they are not consecutive. That means this is the only possible option. So I add this 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So B6 turn out to be 8, and that is our answer.